relation between Imam Bukhari and his teachers. So you say, حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدَانِ. Abdan is one of the teachers of Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. Qala akhbarana Abdullah. So Abdan said akhbarana Abdullah. Abdullah, he informed us. Qala akhbarana Yunus an az-Zuhri. Akhbarana Yunus an az-Zuhri. That Yunus said from az-Zuhri. Anybody remember what we said last time about Imam Zuhri rahimahullah? He's from whom? You mentioned. Thank you for saying that also. We said, if you remember, Imam Zuhri was one of the teachers of Imam Malik, rahimahullah. And we said also, one of the golden chains is when we go from Imam Malik to Az-Zuhri to, subhanAllah, Abdullah ibn Abbas, and then to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you may realize that most of the ahadith or most of the ilm that came, it will come through the chain of Imam Az-Zuhri rahimahullah, which was a tabi'i. So he saw the sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, akhbarana Yunus an Az-Zuhri. So this is one chain. Abdan an Abdullah an Yunus an Az-Zuhri. Then he said, وَحَدَّتَنَا بِشْرُ ibn Muhammad. Then he said, and also Bishr ibn Muhammad حَدَّتَنَا, he told us, قَالَ أَخْبَرَنَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ, the same one, قَالَ أَخْبَرَنَا يُونُسُ وَمَعْمَارُ عَنْ الزُّهْرِ. So he said, this hadith was narrated, or I narrated this hadith through Abdan. And then I narrated the same hadith through another teacher, which is, his name is Bishr ibn Muhammad. But Bishr ibn Muhammad, once he said to hadith to Imam Bukhari rahimahullah, قال أخبرنا عبد الله قال أخبرنا يونس ومعمر. So in the first part, the hadith was narrated from Yunus only, from Zuhri. This way, say Yunus and Ma'mar, both of them, they narrated this hadith from Imam Zuhri. You know why we are talking about those details? Okay, that's one. And also that give you something else. What is it? Who were involved? Where else? Multiple chain. For example, if I said the story, Umair told me the story. So okay, very good. But when I said Umair and Muhammad told me the story, what that makes the story what? A little bit stronger. When I said Muhammad and Umar and Aziz and Khalid, makes the even much stronger. So the Imam Bukhari was not just saying writing those words. No, it was for a purpose. To tell you that this hadith, the sanad of this hadith, the chain of this hadith is so strong, and it's coming always from some trustworthy people, because all the names that I mentioned over here are rijal, some of the people of the hadith, that there are books that called rijal al-hadith, books called only rijal al-hadith. What this book does, only it put the names of those people, and then it tell you the biography of each one of them, where he was born, where he was raised up, what he was doing, what's his job, his family, his wife, his children, and then he'll bring you that. By the way, this type of ilm, ilm al-rijal, does not exist in any civilization except among the Muslims. And the people of ilm al-hadith, they invented this ilm just to protect the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because the people before say, you can say whatever you want. You say, in the beginning, in the time of Rasulullah, of course, Rasulullah was there. In the time of Sahaba, the Sahaba radiallahu anhu was there. In the time of the Tabi'in was there, which is the assistant, and they saw the Sahaba. But after that, people start saying whatever they want. So what they start telling them, bring your man and we'll bring our man also. Meaning, tell me you heard that from who? You cannot just say, Rasulullah said, to say, I heard from such person. So, to make sure that what Rasulullah said is the truth, is not anyone could fabricate anything. So that's the job of Imam Bukhari, or a part of this beautiful job that Imam Bukhari rahimahullah is what we call ilm al-rijal. Going back to the hadith. قَالَ أَخْبَرَنِي عُبَيْدُ اللَّهِ بْنُ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ عَنْ إِبْنِ عَبَّاسِ. So he said, Ubaydullah, son of Abdullah, from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. All of us know Abdullah ibn Abbas, right? Okay, Abdullah ibn Abbas. So what do you think? Anyone? Who is he? Son of Al-Abbas. And who is the Al-Abbas? One of the uncles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right? Let Let's name some of them. Actually, two of them are very famous. Hamza and Al-Abbas. And both of them, they accepted Islam. And others did not accept Islam, like Abu Talib and Abu Jahl. No, Abu Jahl was not. He's a far cousin. He's a cousin. And Abu Lahab, Abu Talib and Abu Lahab. And there are some of the anchors of the Prophet ﷺ that they passed away before even Bi'tah. Before even Bi'tah. Abu Talib or Abdul Muttalib has more than 10 children, actually, the boys. And that's why probably the very famous story when he said, if I get 10 of strong children, I will sacrifice one of them in front of the Kaaba. It will come in the hadith also that inshallah. Coming back again. So he said, Abdullah ibn Abbas, what he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So now he's going to describe Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. By the way, if Abdullah is going to be describing Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, do you know when Abdullah ibn Abbas was born? He was very young when Rasulullah passed away. Probably he was only 10 years old. But did he know that much about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? What do you think? Yes, no? He lives not in the same house, but he used to go there very often. Yes, why? Yeah, there's a very strong reason, by the way. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was married to Maymuna. And Maymuna was the auntie of Abdullah ibn Abbas. So he used to go to the house of Rasulullah sometimes to stay over there overnight. But even there's one hadith, which is the hadith that also give us some information about Abdullah ibn Abbas, that Abdullah ibn Abbas, one time he spent the night in the house of Rasulullah with his khala, Maymuna. So what he said, before Fajr time, I woke up and he was probably 9 years old, and fawada'at wudu'a li Rasulullah. So I prepared the wudu. Some more, and they put it there for Rasulullah so he could do the wudu. So once Rasulullah woke up for that and he wants to make wudu, he said, man wada'a hada, who put this? So Maymuna radiallahu anha said to him, wada'ahu laka Abdullah ibn Abbas. Abdullah, he made it for you, prepared for you. So he made dua for him. He said, Allahumma allimhu ta'wil. Subhanallah. Allahumma faqihu fi al-deen wa allimhu ta'wil. Oh Allah, give him the fiqh, the understanding of the deen, and give him also the knowledge of interpretation of the ahadith and the ayat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's a very famous hadith. The other one, which is also equally famous, of Abdullah ibn Abbas, when he was riding behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Probably some of us who attended the previous khutbah of Mawlana Arshad Mahdi, he mentioned about that hadith, when he was riding behind Rasulullah, and he said to him, Isma' minni ya ghulam. He said to him, listen to me, O young man. Isma' minni kalimat. Listen from me, few words. And then he said, what? احفظ الله يحفظك. احفظ الله يحفظك. O son, O my son, protect the hudud of Allah, Allah will protect you. احفظ الله يحفظك. احفظ الله تجده اتجاهك. Protect the hudud of Allah, you will always find him in front of you, protecting you. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا سَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. And if you are asking, ask Allah. If you need help, ask Allah. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ مَا ضَرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. And if all the people gather to hurt you, to harm you with something, they cannot. But only with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already prescribed for you. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ. And if all of them, they gather to hurt you or to benefit you also with something, they cannot. But only with Allah, something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is prescribed for you. Then he said, جَفَّتِ الْأَقْلَامُ وَالصُّحُفُ. You see, all the pens are finished, meaning the pen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the beginning of this world, what he did. The very first thing that was created by Allah, do you know what is it? Al-Qalam, the pen. So the first thing before anything else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the pen. And then he said to the pen, Uktub, right? So he write the maqadir, the destiny of every single thing in this universe. Me and you, and the ants and the elephants, and the dinosaurs and everything. And all what's going to happen in the future. So he said, جفت الأقلام والصحف. That means Allah already wrote everything, subhanAllah. Going back to the hadith again. So he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. What about him? كان أجود الناس. Everybody knows what the word الناس. What is it? People. We repeat that. قل أعوذ برب الناس. عليك الناس. إله الناس. So الناس means the people. Then he said, كان رسول الله كان. He was أجود الناس. What is أجود? Generous comes from the word Jawad. Jawad, it means generous. Good. The word Jawad in Arabic language has many meanings. One of them means horse also. And actually the Arab used to call the horse Jawad because it helps all the time. I mean, you could use him for your riding, you could use him for your traveling, you could use him in the battlefield, you could also use him when you are hungry and you don't find anything to eat, so you could sacrifice that horse and eat it also. He doesn't like it. Did you eat the horse meat before? Your father has to take you some time. Okay, let me go back again. So he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس. The word أجود, so the word is جواد. And أجود means what? اسم تفضيل. Huh? We say عظيم and أعظم. كبير and أكبر. Huh? صغير and أصغر. And all the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Could you, for example, when somebody does something nice, what do you say? Allahu Akbar. Meaning what? That means whatever you do, Allah is bigger than that, is greater than that. For two reasons. Number one, so that person will not be hit with the ayn, with the eye. That's number one. So, oh, Allahu Akbar. Anything else? Allah is bigger than that. And also when you start your prayer, you say, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Look, the word is kabir, big. But you don't say Allah is big, but you say Allah is bigger, greater than anything else. Why? Because once you make the takbir of ihram, say Allahu Akbar, meaning Allah is bigger, more important than anything else. So everything else has to be behind me, and now I'm what? In conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you're entering the salat by saying Allah is bigger than any other issue, than my family, my worries, my things. So you say Allahu Akbar. Going back again. So he said Rasulullah kana ajwad, meaning that Rasulullah was always jawad, was always generous. But in what's coming? Ajwad, more generous. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس. Compared to anyone, رسول الله was more than that. Then he said, وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان. And the most that used to be more جواد, أجود in رمضان. In the month of Ramadan. May Allah bless all of us with this month that is coming very soon, inshallah. Then he said, why in Ramadan? He gave a beautiful, go ahead. Why in Ramadan Rasulullah will be more generous than in other time? What do you think? Sacred month. What do you think? The Quran was also revealed. Yes. Ramadan, by the way, Quran was revealed in Ramadan in the first heaven. In the first heaven. And but Quran was revealed to the Rasulullah continuously. In Ramadan, in no Ramadan. In Ramadan, in no Ramadan. And it was revealed to Rasulullah sometimes in the daytime, in the nighttime, in the wintertime, in the springtime, and when he was traveling, when he was staying in Mecca, in Medina. So when we say the Quran was revealed in Ramadan in the first heaven, the first sama of dunya, that's what the Quran says, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. And then you find another place you say, Nazzala. Anzala and Nazzala. Both of them means to send down. But the word anzala means he sent all of it in the first heaven. And then nazzala, he sent it continuously in pieces according to the circumstances. Each time there was something, so Allah would send an ayah or few ayahs. Sometimes one whole surah, sometimes half an ayah, sometimes two words. Two words will be sent, subhanAllah. Going back again. So he said, Rasulullah was always to be generous, but more generous in Ramadan. And then he said, حين يلقاه جبريل. When he had a meeting, a gathering with Jibreel, subhanAllah. So some of the Mufassireen, when they explain this word, especially Imam Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, when he did the sharh of Abu Khari, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is more generous than any other time in Ramadan, right? And the khayrat and the barakat in Ramadan is more than any other time. When you do one good deed, sometimes it's multiplied by 10. But in Ramadan, goes to up to 70 or 700 or even more, right? And then the barakat is not only in rizq, in money, but in anything else. In anything else, your good deed will be multiplied. Salat or sawm or hajj or jihad or anything will be multiplied to many, many, many in Ramadan. And this is the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan. So Rasulullah wants to be what? Following the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in Ramadan also, he will become more generous than in any other time. So that's why Rasulullah was more generous in Ramadan compared to any other month. He was always generous. And then very simple, that hadith of that Bedouin who came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he asked him in such a harsh way, he said, give me from the money of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from the money of your father or your mother. He spoke to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like that. Imam al-Anbiya, Taj al-Mursaleen, he spoke to him in a very bad way somehow. Any of us, what are you talking about? Get away. And even the Sahaba, they get angry. Let's just finish with this, guys. No, no, wait. So that's not how we do. So he said to me, you know what? Go between the two valleys, between the two mountains. And whatever you found there, take it. That man said probably he's making fun of me, this guy, or something. So once he went there, he got a lot of goats there. I don't know what's the number, but it's really a huge number. Say, all that for me? He said, all that for you. For who? That person who was talking to him in that way. So once he got all that, he went back to his people, to his tribe, and he said to him, Inna Muhammadan yu'ti ata'a man la yakhsha al-faqr. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gives like someone who is never afraid to be poor. Because whenever we give, we are scared. What's going to happen to me? Right? I'm going to decrease from my bank account. I'm going to decrease. But he say he give like he's not scared to be poor at all. Or in another verse, say, Karrih al-Mursala. Just like the wind, but not like Katrina. He said, like the wind. You know when the wind comes? The wind does not make differences between the people, good and bad, poor and rich. It just comes to everybody, just like the rain. It comes to everybody. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was like that. So going back again to the hadith. So he said, وَكَانَ يَلْقَاهُ كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ فِي رَمَضَانِ. Jibreel used to have a meeting, a sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every night in Ramadan. Now that's the blessing. Now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being blessed in the month of Ramadan, that he will sit, he will have a meeting every day with Jibreel. Rasulullah would not have that every day in the other days with Jibreel alayhi salam. You know, sometimes you will not see him or not meet him for days, right? Then he will wait. Why? He's not coming, my best friend. But in Ramadan, now he has the chance. It's not the chance that he is meeting with Jibreel, although this is something great and something big. But you know what is it? Guess. He is, yes, excellent. The wahi. The word of my Lord is coming to me every day. I will be enjoying the word of my Lord every day. I will be enjoying this conversation with my Lord every day through Jibreel alayhi salam, of course. And you know, the Quran, when it comes from Jibreel, it's fresh. Fresh. It's coming through the word of Jibreel, from Rabbul Izzah to Jibreel alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's why it was a special meeting for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every single night. And that's why for him it was something great. And because it was something great for him every day, so he also every day used to be extra generous for every single person, subhanAllah. كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ مِنْ رَمَضَانِ فَيُدَارِسُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. So he will study the Qur'an with him. What do you mean study the Qur'an with him? You know, the previous hadith when we read it before, you say, when Jibreel used to read the Quran for Rasulullah, Rasulullah used to what? To repeat after him. Why? He was sometimes scared that he will forget, right? Like the ayah say, لَا تُحَرِّكْ بِهِ لِسَانَكَ لِتَعْجَلَ بِهِ. Don't. When Jibreel used to read it, Rasulullah used to repeat after him, using his tongue and his lips. So the Quran said, don't worry, don't repeat after me. Allah will put it in your heart. Now in Ramadan, Jibreel will come to him and he will review the whole Quran with him. This is another proof that the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same that was revealed from Allah to Jibreel to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You cannot say he forgot. And if you say then so, which is that's not possible. Jibreel used to come every year for the whole month reviewing the Quran with Rasulullah, every single ayah. Where this ayah supposed to be, every single letter, every single vowel. So that's why we have this book, the Quran, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be changed. And this was not given to anybody else before him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely gave wahi to Musa wa Isa wa Ibrahim and all those people, but it was not a Quran. And it was not to be renewed every single year with Jibreel alayhi salam. So, فَيُدَارِسُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. So he said, فَلَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ Indeed, fa dan la lam litawkid, for sure, emphasizing that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة. He is so generous with khayr, with all the good things, than even the wind. We say the wind gives to everybody. Rasulullah is even more than that, subhanAllah. May Allah forgive all of us. If you have any questions or comments, otherwise we'll make dua, inshallah. Okay, just a small reminder. Next week, inshallah, it will be the sixth hadith, and that's a very long hadith, the hadith of Abu Sufyan. It's a long hadith which has almost two pages. When Abu Sufyan went to the to Qaisar and to Hercule, and then he was talking to him about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Please go and read it before we come, inshallah, so we can have a better discussion, inshallah. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وإليه المصير وعلى كل شيء قدير ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
يا أيها المتميزون يا المتميزون المدح فيكم ذو شجون المؤمنون الصالحون الصادقون المتقون الصائمون القائمون الصابرون المنفقون يا أيها المتميزون المدح فيكم ذو شجون المؤمنون الصالحون الصادقون المتقون الصائمون القائمون الصابرون المنفقون الشاكرون الذاكرون الله والمستغفرون السائرون على هدى القرآن والمتوكلون الراغبون بجنة الفردوس والمستبشرون الآملون برؤية الرحمن والمتشوقون هذا ومنهم ثلة عند الإله مقربون وأولو يمين دونهم عند الكريم مكرمون كل أتاه جزاؤه عدلا وهم لا يظلمون بل إن فضل الله فوق جميع ما يتصورون إذ إن فضل إلهنا ليست تحيط به الظنون يا رب بألحقنا بمن يجري لهم دمع العيون أيها المتميزون المدح فيكم ذو شجون المؤمنون الصالحون الصادقون المتقون الصائمون القائمون الصابرون المنفقون الشاكرون الذاكرون الله والمستغفرون السائرون على هدى القرآن والمتوكلون الراغبون بجنة الفردوس والمستبشرون الآملون برؤية الرحمن والمتشوقون هذا ومنهم ثلة عند الإله مقرب وأولو يمين دونهم عند الكريم مكرمون كل أتاه جزاؤه عدلا وهم لا يظلمون بل إن فضل الله فوق جميع ما يتصورون إذ إن فضل إلهنا ليست تحيط به الظنون يا رب بألحقنا بمن يجري لهم دمع العيون ذكراهم تهني على جدب القلوب كملموزون تحيي العزيمة والكرامة في إباء لا يهون فعسى نسير بسيرهم دوما كما كانوا نكون كانوا نجوما للسرات لأنهم متميزون